Hi everyone, and welcome to October Tech Bytes. This episode is called What's New with Google. To start off with, the name of Google Apps for Education is now changing, and it's now being called G Suite Edu. In this episode, we're going to go over some new things in Google Docs, Google Forms, and Google Classroom. What's new in Google Docs? Well, now you can add columns in Google Docs. Go to Format, Columns, and choose between two or three columns. You can choose two columns. You can also, if you would prefer to have lines in between your columns, go to More Options and make sure that you have this checked, Line Between Columns. And here, again, you can switch from one to two to three. If I wanted to do three, and I want to put line in between columns, hit apply. And then after you type and you go down your column and you go to the next column, the line will appear. And then you can start typing in your next column. Same thing, go to your third column and the line appears. Then you can go in between columns once you have text in all three columns. You can adjust the size of the columns here if you wish to do so, or you can do that under Format, under More Options, and you can change the spacing here as well. So that's what's new in Google Docs. What's new in Google Forms? Well, a lot of things are new in Google Forms. One of the main things is that you can now use Google Forms to create a quiz, and it will self-grade it right here in Google Forms without having to use an add-on. You just click on the settings cog, go to quizzes, and say make this a quiz. Then you can give it options here, hit save, and then once you create a question, it gives you edit question, or you can put an answer key in here. And you can tell it what the right answer is, how many points it's worth, and so forth. Then, when you go to the responses, it will have it all graded right there for you. You can also, under responses, create a spreadsheet right here by clicking on the spreadsheet icon. You can also insert images, YouTube videos, and you can change your color palette. But previously with the new Google Forms, all you had the option to do was use colors. Now you can click on the image and it brings up what used to be available in your old Google Forms, and you can put a theme on it. So if you haven't switched to new Google Forms, please do so. And once you do, you will love it. So that's what's new in Google Forms. What's new in Google Classroom? Well, if you notice, there are different options over here. Have you tried to create a question? Creating a question allows your students to answer the question, and they can reply to each other's comments if you wish for them to do so. There's also a new feature under Students where you can invite guardians, and they will receive an email every week about what's going on in your Google Classroom. It does not give them access to your Google Classroom stream, but it does give them the opportunity to see what's going on and what assignments might be due. Also, remember that you can either invite students manually, or you can just give them the class code that is automatically generated for them. One thing about the About, you may want to put a hyperdoc in here with all of your resources so that students don't get any of your resources lost in the stream. If you keep everything on one hyperdoc, it's very easy to just add information so that they will always be able to access it. You can add anything for units, you can add online resources, you can add your proficiency scales, everything links to something, and it stays right here in your Google About page. Any changes that you do to your hyperdoc automatically get updated so that you always have the most updated resources here in your About page. So again, what's new? What's new is Invite Guardians. And under your stream, you can now create questions. You can also reuse a post. And if you have more than one post, you can also bring one of your posts back up to the top so it doesn't get lost in your stream. So that's what's new with Google Classroom.